NASA experts are getting ready to study dust lifted from the surface of a rock flying through the galaxy. The dust is the largest ever sample of an asteroid called Bennu and landed in Utah, USA last night. The spacecraft that went to get it is called Osiris-Rex and blasted off in 2016, travelling millions of miles to find this precious dust, which could reveal secrets about how and why Earth exists. Here's BBC expert Rebecca Morell with more.
The SRC has entered the Earth's atmosphere.
A first glimpse of the capsule after its epic journey through space.
We have confirmed parachute deployment.
High up in the atmosphere, a parachute opens, slowing its descent.
Touchdown. I repeat, EDL. SRC has touchdown.
A textbook landing in the middle of the Utah desert. For Dante Loretta, the lead scientist, it was an emotional moment.
So how did it go?
It went absolutely perfectly. Absolutely perfect landing. We stuck it, we didn't move. We landed in nice soft soil. The capsule looked flawless.
I cried like a baby in that helicopter when I heard that the parachute had opened and we were coming in for a soft landing. It was just an overwhelming moment for me.
Inside this capsule is the most precious sample, fragments of an asteroid called Bennu.
This is the moment that NASA has been waiting for. After 7 long years, travelling billions of miles to Bennu and back, the capsule is finally here.
So why go to all of this effort? Bennu could also reveal more about our origins. It's a perfectly preserved relic from the dawn of the solar system. It's going to keep scientists busy for a long time.
We take 75% of that sample and we're going to lock it away for future generations, people who haven't even been born yet, to work in laboratories that don't exist yet, and instrumentation that you haven't thought of yet. So, I mean, it's an incredibly valuable, valuable sample that we're bringing back.
The next stage of this mission will involve this military cargo plane. The canister containing the sample will be packaged up and loaded onto it and flown to the Johnson Space Center in Houston, where scientists are waiting to start the most exciting bit, opening it up to see exactly what's inside.